Electronic engineering as a science is developing rapidly. Almost everything we use on a day-to-day basis, from our mobile phones to our watches, has some form of electronic component. Our electronic engineering degree will prepare you for a career in industry where you're designing and building these components and linking them together into mechanical and electronic engineering systems, such as robotics.
When I was young, I always wanted to be able to like build robots and things, and now that I know more about it, like I do enjoy the electronics and component side of things way more than I thought I would.
The science of electronic engineering has developed rapidly in the last few years. The availability of microprocessor systems such as Arduinos and Raspberry Pis means that we can program and design to a much higher level of detail.
I specifically chose electronic engineering because I knew it was quite math intensive and I quite enjoy the math side of things, so I was quite excited to do that.
The course will have a focus on some of the underpinning theory that you need as a professional engineer, along with the underpinning mathematics and the underpinning physics. It will also look at the use of embedded systems, how we can use Raspberry Pis and Arduinos as part of engineering systems, and will allow you to build up a complete knowledge so that you can look at a problem and design a solution to it.
So far, I absolutely love the work we're doing. For me, it's a great benefit because I actually get to use these skills and get to use what we've learned and what we've been taught within my actual day job. So I'm actually a part-time student at Solent University. I come down every Tuesday to do my lessons and my courses. I am actually an electronic engineer whereby I look at embedded systems.
One of the highlights of the course for students is designing and building small robots. These are line-following robots that race around a predetermined racetrack. We then put obstacles in their way and they have to use ultrasound sensors and programming to move around them and avoid a collision.
And for me, I can actually take this back to work and understand and dive deeper into the work that I'm doing and show that my understanding is more capable with the level that I'm at with my day job.
As part of the assessment for this course, you'll build and race these robots and really understand how theory translates into practice.
It's been a great learning curve because for me, I'm not used to using Arduino code or Arduino IDE. I'm used to using different platforms at work, so being able to expand my knowledge has been brilliant.
Throughout the course, there'll be a focus on how you can use what you've learned in industry. Your coursework and assessments will have a practical focus in terms of work that simulates industry and will prepare you ready for a job at the end of graduation.
Second year has been extremely hands-on and you get to like really explore subjects on your own as opposed to being led through them, which I think is great.
In the final year of the course, you'll be able to undertake your own research project, looking at a certain topic of your choice and researching it in depth, either as a scientific principle or as an application to a problem.
One of my favourite things is to go into the lab and mess with all the equipment and you literally get like hands on everything, like all the way from like an Arduino mini to like literally the digital oscilloscopes and like whatever you want is in the lab for you to use whenever.
We have some fantastic facilities, including our control systems laboratory, that I'm studying at the moment, and a dedicated electronics engineering laboratory. We also have some computing laboratories that you can use for programming to hone your skills and learn how to program some systems like Raspberry Pis and Arduinos.
If you're doing your own project, building a robot or like making an app or whatever the case may be, you can literally come in every day of the week and just sit in the back of the lab and do whatever you want. And we've got the technicians there to always give you, they'll literally just give you the equipment. Like you, so super helpful when you're trying to get a project done that's not like, it's not part of the syllabus.
The staff on our electronic engineering degree come from a range of backgrounds, with some having an academic background and some having an applied background having worked in industry. This means that during the course you'll be exposed to a range of different ideas and viewpoints, allowing you to build and construct your knowledge from a different set of perspectives.
I feel that at Solent, you've been prepared for industry quite well because a lot of the teachers and professors that have taught here or do teach here actually came from like a long background in industry. Some just from research, but a lot of them have been in industry for a long time and have then come here to teach once they've got their doctorate or something along those lines. So a lot of the time when you're doing laboratories, they'll explain how it actually works in industry and how you would make this applicable.
The staff in our department have a really good network of professional connections, which allows us to bring in guest lectures and guest speakers, and allows us to bring in some live briefs for assessments. As part of our course, you will be exposed to industry, and you'll be able to understand from an early point how the industry works and how your skills as a professional engineer fit in.
There's a large focus on making sure that you have a good career path ahead of you outside of the university and afterwards. They'll constantly be trying to get you to do summer internships and things along those lines, so they're just constantly making sure that you're prepared as possible for the future road ahead.